Hello friends, I am Silas Joseph and today we are going to discuss two topics that are electric field on the equatorial line of a dipole and force on an electric dipole in a uniform electric field. So these are the topics that we have chosen today. So in the last section we have discussed about the relations for finding the electric field on the axis of the dipole axis of an electric dipole, isn't it? So today we are going to discuss how to find the relation for finding electric field on the equatorial line of the dipole. So that's our first topic, so we can go to that directly. So that is electric field on the equatorial line of a electric dipole. So first of all, you have to consider an electric dipole, and you may aware about what is electric dipole, isn't it? Electric dipole is a combination of two charges having the same magnitude but in different, which means opposite charges. Okay, so first consider plus Q, minus Q here, and this one is plus Q, and they are separated with a small distance. Let's call it as, let's take the distance as 2A. Clear? So you can consider the midpoint, and this will be the center of dipole, isn't it? So these things we have discussed in the previous section. So in the previous section we have discussed for the relation for finding the electric field somewhere on the electric dipole axis, isn't it? That we have found in last classes. So in today's class we are going to find the relation for the electric field in the equatorial line. And what is the equatorial line? It is a line which is passing through the center of the dipole, which means the vertical, the perpendicular line which is passing through the center of the line is called equatorial line. Clear? And our aim is to find the electric field over this particular equatorial line. And for that we can choose any point P at a distance r from the dipole axis. Clear? So it is placed at a distance of r from the center of the dipole. So due to this point Q and plus Q, definitely this point P will experience an electric field, isn't it? And we may know that the strength of electric dipole will be expressed using the term dipole moment, isn't it? And dipole moment is represented by capital P, and which is equal to charge into the distance of separation, that is 2A. Clear? And this is the strength. This will give you the strength of the dipole. Clear? So this is dipole moment Q into 2A, and the direction of this particular dipole moment will be directed from negative to positive charge. So this will be the direction of electric dipole. Clear? And due to this plus Q and minus Q, this point P will experience an electric field. So we can consider, so definitely there will be line of action will be there. Okay, then the distance from this point to the center will be A. You can consider it as A, and this one is also A. Clear? And due to plus Q, definitely it will experience an electric field, and we can call it as EQ, E plus Q. And due to this charge minus Q, this point P will experience an electric field, and that can be represented by E minus Q. Clear? And we know the relation for finding relation for the electric field due to a charge Q, isn't it? And that will be equal to, how we can found that one? Electric field E equals K into charge divided by square of the distance of separation. This is the general relation for finding the electric field. K is for the proportionality constant, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 times Q by R square, isn't it? So this is the relation for finding the electric field somewhere at a distance of R. Clear? So we can use this relation for finding E minus Q, E plus Q and E minus Q for this point P. And for that we require this distance, isn't it? And for that purpose we can use the Pythagoras theorem, and that manner we can say, we can consider it as a right angle triangle, and this is the base and this is the altitude. So this is the longer one, that is the hypotenuse. So the distance from this charge to this particular point will be equal to square root of A square plus R square. And similarly for this side also it will be A square plus R square. Okay, now we have got the distance of this point from these two charges. So in that manner we can say E plus Q will be equal to, so So you can see one more thing, the charges, the magnitude of charges for these two will be same. So definitely the electric field experienced in this particular point P due to this minus Q and plus Q will be same in magnitude, but their direction will be opposite, isn't it? So we can say E plus Q will be equal to E minus Q, and which is equal to K times charge, that is magnitude Q, divided by square of the distance, and distance is square root of A square plus R square, the whole square, that is A square plus R square. Clear? So this will be the magnitude of electric field experienced on the point P. We know that the total electric field experienced here cannot be said to be equal to the sum of this E plus Q, E minus Q. There we have to use the superposition principle, isn't it? We have to consider the vector sum of this electric field. So now we are going to the vector concept at this particular point P, and we know that due to plus Q, this P point, the point P will experience an electric field, and that electric field will be directed away from the charge plus Q, isn't it? And we can represent it as E plus Q. By the same way, the electric field experienced on P due to this minus Q, charge will be directed towards the charge, that is minus negative charge, that is E minus Q. Clear? So the vector sum of this E minus Q and E plus Q will give you the total electric field experienced on this particular point P, which is at a distance of R from the center of the dipole or from the dipole axis. Clear? So now our aim is to find the total electric field experienced on this equatorial point. Clear? So for that, we can use the concept of vector. Vector concept, you have to mainly the component idea. So for that, you can consider the angle be theta here. So right angle triangle is angle have theta angle here. Correspondingly, this angle will also be theta. And here you can consider the component ideas of vector. In that manner, you can consider two components. One is vertical and one is horizontal. Clear? And definitely this E plus Q will have a horizontal component and also a vertical component. Clear? And the angle here, if this angle is theta, then definitely we can say that this angle seems to be theta here. And here this angle is theta, this is corresponding angle concept, alternate angle concept we can use there, then theta, and definitely this angle will be theta, then opposite, vertical opposite angle will be same, that also, this one is also theta. Clear? So we can say the components of E plus Q along this horizontal direction will be E plus Q cos theta. Clear? And that on the vertical will be E plus Q sin theta. Clear? That's the vector concept. So using the vector component concept, we can say that there will be two components for this E plus Q vector, and that will be E plus Q sin theta. That will be the vertical component directing in the upward direction, and E plus Q cos theta in the horizontal direction. Clear? And similarly for E minus Q, definitely there will be two components. One will be vertically downward, and that can be represented as E minus Q sin theta, and the horizontal one will be E minus Q sin theta. Okay. Clear? So we have got all the components of these two vectors, that is E plus Q and E minus Q. E plus Q sin theta vertically upward, E minus Q sin theta vertically downward for the E minus Q, and horizontal components are E plus Q and E minus Q sin theta. Clear? Now we have to take the vector sum of these, then only we will get the total electric field acting at this particular point P. Now you can see the magnitude of E plus Q sin theta and E minus Q sin theta will be same, isn't it? And they are acting in opposite direction, so the total effect will be zero. Clear? So we can remove this particular idea of E plus Q and E minus Q. Then the total electric field will be clearly due to this E plus Q cos theta and this E minus Q cos theta. E minus Q cos theta. This is the horizontal component for E minus Q. Clear? So that will be the vector sum of this E plus Q cos theta and E minus Q cos theta. So the net electric field acting will be equal to E plus Q cos theta plus E minus Q cos theta. The magnitude of E plus Q cos theta and E minus Q cos theta are same only, so we can write it as 2EQ cos theta. Clear? Okay, and we know that EQ can be represented as KQ divided by square of the distance, that is A square plus R into cos theta. Then, now again we can simplify this one by using the ideas of cos theta. We can find the value of cos theta using this right angle triangle. And here cos theta, how will you find the cos theta? Base by hypotenuse, isn't it? And here this is the base and that is A. And hypotenuse is square root of A square plus R square. So we can say that cos theta equals A by A square plus R square. Clear? I am putting the value of cos theta here. This relation will change to 2k q divided by A square plus R square into cos theta, that is A divided by square root of A square plus R square. Clear? Now, we can check this relation, that is 2kqa, that is we can bring this idea of strength of dipole, that is dipole moment, that is dipole moment is equal to q into 2a. So we can rewrite this as p. So this relation will change to kp divided by this a square plus r square into square root of a square plus r square. What is that? It will come as a square plus r square all raised to 1 plus 1 by 2, that is 3 by 2. Clear? So this will be the total electric field acting on this particular point P due to charges on the electric dipole, that is minus Q and plus Q. And we know one more thing, the distance of separation between the two charges of electric dipole will be very small, isn't it? So the value of 2A, we can let consider one identity, that is let 2A be too small when comparing with R. So in the by that manner we can say that the value of A square will be very small. So we can neglect this particular A square value from this relation. By that manner we will get the total electric field on the equatorial point due to this electric dipole will be equal to Kp divided by R square whole raised to 3 by 2, and that is Rq. So this is the relation for finding the electric field on the equatorial line of an electric dipole. And you can see the direction of this particular electric field will be in this direction. Clear? Because E plus Q cos theta, E minus Q cos theta are the electric field components, so the direction will be clearly in this direction. And you can see the direction of electric field is opposite to the direction of dipole moment. Isn't it? The direction of electric field is opposite. So in the case of electric dipole, which means the last section we are discussing the electric field on the point somewhere on the dipole axis, we are seeing that both are the same direction, isn't it? That we are discussed last day in the last section. And in this section we can see that on the equatorial line the direction of the electric field is opposite to the direction of electric dipole. So if you want to express this relation in terms of vector identities, in terms of directions, then it will be E minus Kp by Rq, where this minus is representing the direction of electric field and which is opposite to the direction of dipole moment. And you can see this electric field is inversely proportional to cube of the distance of separation between the center of the dipole and the point that we are considering on the equatorial line. Clear? So this is the method to find the electric field acting on an equatorial point which is due to the electric dipole. Clear? And that will be equal to E equals Kp by R cube, and this minus sign is representing the direction in which the dipole electric field is opposite to the dipole moment. And you can see the value of electric field on the equatorial line is half of the value of electric field on the dipole axis due to the electric dipole. Isn't it? In the last section we have said electric field due to this electric dipole on the axis seems to be E is equal to 2Kp divided by Rq, isn't it? In that manner we have got. And when you're comparing these two values, you can see electric field on the equatorial line seems to be half of the electric field acting on the dipole axis due to the electric dipole. Clear? So this is about the electric field on the equatorial line of the dipole. Clear? Now we can move to our second topic, that is the force on the electric dipole when it is placed in an external electric field. Force on electric dipole in an external electric field. Clear? So you can consider an external electric field, and let it be uniform electric field we can consider. Okay, just consider a uniform electric field. And what is this uniform electric field? For uniform electric field, the value and the magnitude of electric field will be same in all points. If you take this point or this point or this point or here, the value or the magnitude and the direction of the electric field will be constant, which means it will remain same. So this is our electric field, external electric field, and to this electric field we are placing our electric dipole. And what is this electric dipole? It's a system of two charges having the same magnitude but opposite nature, which means opposite charges separated by a small distance. Let the distance be 2a. Clear? And this is plus q and this one is minus q charge. Okay, and which we are placed with an angle theta of separation here. Okay, so this is our electric dipole and we are placed in an external electric field. And our aim is to find the force. We know that when a charge is placed on an electric field, definitely it will experience an electrostatic force, and that can be found by using the relation F is equal to QE. And that electrostatic force will be, for the case of charge, if it is a positively charged, then it will be in the same direction of the external electric field, and if it is a negative charge, it will be in the opposite direction when comparing with the external electric field. Isn't it? So that's the case for this electrostatic force acting on this particle. Definitely this two point charges will definitely get an electrostatic force, and we can say the force acting on this plus two charge due to this electric field will be directed in the same direction of the electric field, and that will be equal to F is equal to QE. And similarly for the case of minus Q, there also an electrostatic force will be there due to this electric field, and that will be directed opposite to the direction of the electric field, and that the value will be F is equal to QE. The magnitude of the force acting on the two charges seems to be same only. So we can say that the net force acting on this electric dipole due to this external electric field will be zero. That we can say the force net for external force acting on this charge will be equal to zero. Clear? Because you can see the forces F is equal to QE for plus Q, and that is the same for the case of minus Q, and they are acting in the opposite direction, so definitely the net force will be zero. And in this case you can see even the net force is zero, these forces are acting in the opposite direction, and this dipole can make a rotation around that particular electric field, which means a torque is coming in action. So definitely due to this forces, couple of forces, we can say that two equal and opposite forces are acting on a body, so definitely there will be a rotation will take place, which means a torque will take place there, and in that manner we can say the experience, the torque acting on this body can be found by using the relation force into perpendicular distance between the point of action and the line of action, isn't it? So now our aim is to find the torque acting on this particular electric dipole. Clear? And we know the value of force, that is equal to QE. Now we have to find the perpendicular distance. Okay. So for finding the perpendicular, we know that this is the force acting on plus Q and this is the force acting on minus Q. So you can consider the line of action of this particular two electrostatic forces, and this is the line of action for plus Q charge, and this is the line of action of force for the case of minus Q charge. Clear? And now we can find the perpendicular distance, and the perpendicular distance will be this one. Our perpendicular distance between this line of action. Now our aim is to find this perpendicular distance. So for that we can use the trigonometric identities. So we know that this dipole is making an angle theta with this uniform electric field. So definitely this angle will be theta here. And we want to find this particular length. So for that we have the hypotenuse value, that is 2a, and we can use the ideas of sine components, that is sine theta. and sine theta will be equal to, let's put this distance of x. So it will be x divided by 2a, or from here we can say x equals 2a sine theta. Clear? Now we can put this value, that is x means the perpendicular distance. We can put this value here in this relation for torque, and that manner we can say torque equals force into 2a sine theta, and this force, the value of force will be, magnitude will be qe. So qe into 2a sine theta. And in this relation you can see the term q2a is there. And what is that? This, that is the dipole moment. What is dipole moment? It can give you the strength of the electric dipole, and that electric dipole P is equal to q into 2a, and the direction of this dipole moment will always from negative to positive, isn't it? So we can replace this relation and we can write up P E sine theta or P cross E. So this is the relation for finding the torque taking place on an electric dipole when it is placed in an external electric field. You can use this relation, one is P E sine theta or P cross E. And the direction of torque will definitely, the direction which is the product of P cross E, the vector product of this P cross E will give you the direction of the torque. We can use the right hand thumb rule for finding that particular direction. Okay, so torque is equal to P cross E. Clear? So this is the torque taking place. So when we are placing an electric dipole, if it makes an angle theta, definitely it will experience a torque. In that manner, it will make a rotation and it will try to make a place which is parallel to the external electric field. So to that particular point, it will make a rotation, and once it becomes parallel, then definitely the value of theta will be zero, and we know that sine theta, sine zero will be zero only, so there will be no more torque on that particular dipole. So the, if we can consider one case, that is if theta equals 0 degree, then definitely we can say that the dipole will be aligned in this surface of external electric field, and our charges will be likewise. So the charge is zero only, the angle theta is zero, so definitely the torque acting on this body will be zero and the force acting will be zero itself. Clear? So that's the case we can say when theta is equal to zero, and we can consider this particular case as equilibrium. You can see it is equilibrium because it is not making any type of movement change there, so we can consider it as a stable equilibrium case. At the same time, if the angle is 180 degrees, then also the system will be in equilibrium, but it will be in an unstable manner, isn't it? Because you can see plus Q is here and minus Q seems to be here in the external electric field. Then we know that electric dipole moment is acting in this direction and which is making a 180 degree, so definitely there will be force will be there, but this body will try to be, it is aligned in itself, isn't it? So in that manner we can call it as unstable equilibrium. So we can say if the angle of suppression, the angle theta is equal to zero, then it is called stable equilibrium, and if it is 180, then it is called unstable equilibrium. Clear? So this is the force on the electric dipole due to an external electric field. So when we are placing an electric dipole in an external electric field, definitely it will experience a force of QE which will be opposite in nature, so that means total net force will be zero. And even though due to this opposite forces, it will experience a torque, a rotation will take place. That torque can be formed by using the relation torque is equal to PE sine theta or P cross E, and the direction of the torque will be formed by using, by finding the vector product of P cross E. Clear? So this is about our today's section. So we have discussed two things. First one, how to find the electric field on the equatorial line of an electric dipole, and the second one is force on the electric dipole on external electric field. Clear? I hope you are clear with this particular point. I will catch you with some more exercise portion for this particular chapter in the next class. Okay.